Mr. Spark, the women on your planet are logical. That's the only planet in this galaxy that can make that claim.
If you don't want the obligations that go along with the title, then give it up.
Nobody speaks to me that way.
That's another one of your problems. Nobody's told you that you're an uncivilized savage, a vicious child in a woman's body, an arrogant monster. That's no way to treat someone who's telling you the truth. Tomorrow's lesson will be on courtesy.
No one may enter the Dolman's presence.
Where's Crichton?
On business. No one may enter the Dolman's presence.
Will you tell Her Glory that Captain Kirk requests the honor of a visit?
The Dolman has promised that I will be whipped to death if I let Captain Kirk pass through that door.
Spock, when they wake up, take them to security hold.
Captain, your analysis of the situation was flawless, anticipating that she would deny you admittance. However, the logic by which you arrived at your conclusion escapes me.
Mr. Spock, the women on your planet are logical. That's the only planet in this galaxy that can make that claim.
You dare touch a member of the royal family?
Only in self-defense.
Now, are you going to behave or not?
The penalty is death for what you are doing.
We're not on the lass. We're on my starship. I command here.
You are warned, Captain, never to touch me again.
If I touch you again, Your Glory, it'll be to administer an ancient Earth custom called a spanking, a form of punishment administered to spoiled brats.
You have my leave to go.
You forget, Your Glory, we haven't started your lesson in courtesy.
You can teach me nothing, Captain. If I have to stay here for 10 light years, I will not be soiled by any contact with you.
Very well, I'll send in Mr. Spock. Or Dr. McCoy.